Today's homework from chapter number 1, question number 7. A shiny brown colored element X on heating in air becomes black colored compound. Name the element X and the black colored compound formed. Answer: X is a copper metal. On heating in air, it gets oxidized to form CuO, which is black in color. Equation for the reaction: 2Cu solid state plus O2 in the gaseous state on heating gives above the arrow mark, you write heat 2CuO, that is in the solid state. Question number 18, already we have discussed, so refer that one. Question number 9, oil and fats containing food items are flushed with nitrogen, why? Answer, the food items containing oil and fat are flushed with nitrogen because oil and fat become rancid on oxidation, which has the bad taste and smell. The nitrogen flushing prevents the oxidation of food so that it does not become rancid. Note, food is kept in refrigerator so as to reduce the temperature, which slows down the rate of oxidation and preserves the food for longer time. Question number 20. Explain the following terms with one example each. A. Corrosion. B. Rancidity. Answer: A. Corrosion. It is a process in which metal reacts with substances present in atmosphere to form surface compounds. For example, iron reacts with oxygen in the presence of moisture and forms rust. Silver turns black due to the formation of silver sulfide, Ag2S, and copper turns green due to the formation of basic copper carbonate. Rust is Fe2O3XH2O in general. B. Rancidity. It is a process in which food material gets spoiled when it comes in contact with oxygen. It leads to the change in taste and smell of food materials. For example, butter gets spoiled due to oxidation at room temperature. If kept for a longer time, it becomes sour in taste and gives a foul smell. The product formed on oxidation of food is rancid, and such a process is called rancidity. In the previous classes, we have learned what are indicators, what are the different types of indicators, and the use of indicators, that is synthetic and natural indicators, in testing the acids and bases. Similarly, olfactory indicators also used to test the acids and bases. Let us learn the action of olfactory indicators with acids and bases. Activity 2.2. Take some finely chopped onions in a plastic bag along with some strips of clean cloth. Tie up the bag tightly and leave overnight in the fridge. The cloth strips can now be used to test for acids and bases. Just you are taking the onion, chopped onion, in a plastic bag along with your keeping some clean cloth, tie it tightly and then keep it in the refrigerator. Take two of these cloth strips and check their odor. Keep them on a clean surface and put a few drops of dilute HCl solution on one strip and few drops of dilute NaOH solution on the other. On the surface of the cloth, in one you are adding dilute HCl and another cloth strip you are adding NaOH. Rinse both cloth strips with water and again check the odor. Note your observations. What are you observing? Just note it down. Now take some dilute vanilla essence and glove oil and check their odor. Take some dilute HCl solution in one test tube and dilute NaOH solution in another, that is acid in one, base in another. Add a few drops of dilute vanilla essence to both test tubes and shake well. check the order once again and record changes in order if any. Similarly, test the change in the order of glove oil with dilute HCl and dilute NaOH solutions and record your observations. We observed that onion have a characteristic smell in the acidic medium, which is completely destroyed in basic medium. Vanilla solution produces specific smell in acidic solution, that is in HCl, but no smell in basic solution in NaOH. Glove oil produces different odor in different medium. From that, we come to conclusion that the onion, vanilla essence, glove oil, which have different odors in different mediums, can be used as olfactory indicators.